Hello everyone, welcome to this video series where I am talking about how to write unit test code in Python programming language using the built-in unit test framework. In this particular video, we will talk about some of the basic assertions which we can use to verify our tests. The assertions which I am going to tell you should cover more than 50% of your unit test requirements. So let's go ahead and start. So now the code which you are seeing on your screen is the basic skeleton of a unit test framework. If you are not aware of this, I will highly recommend you to go ahead and see my video on beginner introduction to unit test. I will provide the link in the description section. So if I go ahead and run this code, you can see it says that it has ran one test and one test is passed. Now let's go ahead and create some variable. Let me create a equal to 1 and b equal to 1. Now, how do my test case will check whether A and B are indeed equal? Well, we can write a if condition, right? If A equal to B, I can say print same, okay? So if I go ahead and run this code, you can see that in debug console, same is being printed. And if that is not the case, I'll say print not same, okay? And I say B equal to 10 so that it is not same. You can see that in debug console, it is saying not same. But how do I know that this test is failed or passed? Okay, I cannot go ahead and see my hundreds of unit tests to verify the print statement, to see whether the print statement corresponds to success or failure. Okay, that's the precise reason unit test framework, or for that matter, any unit test framework in any programming language provides us test assertions. So we can use test assertions in this particular way. We will have to say self, we'll have to invoke the test assertions in this particular class, and I say assert equal. Assert equal is one of the assertion, and I can say A comma B. So as the name specifies, it checks whether the A and B are indeed equal. So if I go ahead and run this code, you can see in the debug console, it says that assertion error 1 is not equal to 10. And it says that one test has failed. So in this particular way, we will know which test has failed and where. And if I change it back to 1, the test will pass and there will not be any error message. Okay, so that's the way we write basic assertions, and assert equal is all about checking whether two variables are equal or not. Now, similar to assert equal, there is something called not equivalent of all the assertions that is there in unit test framework. Now, if we go back and say b equal to 10 and run this test, this will fail because anyway 1 is not equal to 10. But what if you want to check that these two are not equal? That's the reason unit test framework provides us a negative case scenario for most of the assertions, and it is called assert not equal. So if we can say assert not equal. In this case, if we go ahead and run this code, the test will pass because we are checking for inequality, and that's the reason this test is passing. So most of the assertions will have a positive test case scenario as well as a negative test case scenario. Now let's go back to assert equal and run this particular code. You can see that it is actually failing and we get this particular error, right? Now what if we don't like this error? Somehow it's difficult for us to understand and we want our custom error. We can do it in all the assertion in unit test by passing a parameter called msg and your custom message saying 1 is not equal to 10. Now we have looked into assert equal. Let's explore some other things also. There is something called assert age. So if I can say self dot assert age, okay, I can say A comma B. Age A and B are same. So if I go ahead and run this code, you can see that this test is failed because it says 1 is not 10, A is not B. What if I give both A and B as 1? We can actually run the code and can see that this test is actually passing. So in this particular case, in primitive types, it's actually checking the value. Now let's create a test class. For example, let's create a class called test. I'll just pass it. And also create a class called test1. and pass the same. And let me create an instance of both test and test1. Let me get rid of this. I'll say t1 equal to test and I say t2 equal to t1. Okay. Now, if I pass assert age t1 comma t2, what do you think the output will be? Guess before continuing this video. So, if I go ahead and run this particular code, it is saying successful, both t1 and t2 are same. But if I go ahead and change the t2 as new instance of test and go ahead and run this code, you can see that it is failed because they are two different instances. This is helpful in checking if the both instances are same or not. Okay, similar to assert is, there is something called assert is not. Okay, so if I go ahead and run this particular code, this will pass because we are checking the negative scenario over here. There is one more assertion which talks about instances, and that assertion is called self.assert is instance. Okay, so let me get rid of this. What I am checking over here is that if t1 is the instance of test, let me go ahead and run this particular code. It will say yes, indeed t1 is the instance of test. I can check if t1 is the instance of test1. This test will fail, saying that t1 is not the instance of test1. Again, if you are not comfortable with this particular message, you can provide your own custom message by saying message equal to instance mismatch. Okay, and if we go ahead run this code, we can see instance mismatch over here. And the negative of this is assert not is instance. And if we go ahead and run this code, the test will pass because we are checking for negative scenario. Now, similar to this, there is something called assert is none, assert is not none. So let's, for example, create a variable t3 is equal to none. We can check whether self assert is none t3. Okay. If we go ahead and run this code, test will pass because t3 is indeed none. And if I pass some value in t3, this test will fail. You can see that 10 is not none. The negative of assert is none is assert is not none. And if we go ahead and run this code now, you can see tests are passing. Now, similar to these things, there is a assert true and assert false, which is very simple. We can say self dot assert true. If 10 is equal to 10 is assert true, and test will pass. We can also say assert t1 is equal to t2. What will be the output? What do you think? Are t1 and t2 equal? If we go ahead and run this code, we come to know that no, they are not. But if I say t1 is equal to t1, the test will pass. Okay. If we go ahead and say t1 is equal to t2, but make it assert false, this test will pass. Okay. So that's the basic set of assertions which you can use in your unit test framework. In the next video, we will talk about how to assert for exceptions. Okay. Till that time, thank you. Thanks a lot. Good day.